Namaskarams and greetings to all the dignitaries, Sangeeta Kalanidhi elect, my brother from Guru, Sri TVG sir. It is a little known fact that I was one of his dropout students in Vidhanam. But it was such a privilege to interact with him and learn from him, so my greetings to him, to Kapu sir, Murli sir, Shankaran sir, Chandrasekharan sir, and so many other great Vidwans who are assembled here today. It's with humility that I approach this topic, because numbers rule the universe in so many ways, and they're a fascinated man. Some of these things you would have already glanced at, and India has been particularly a strong, significant contributor in the world of mathematics for millennia. In fact, many concepts which are attributed, which are attributed to latter-day mathematicians in the West, have been propounded by Indian mathematicians millennia ago. And now it is getting well known. So, music, of course, Carnatic music is world renowned for its supremacy in organized mathematical patterns. That said, composers have definitely used patterns. In fact, it's more a lyrical concept in many, many ways. Whatever we are doing in music is an extension of the chandas that was there in lyrics for many, many centuries. And some of those have been extrapolated into music. And in Carnatic music, we have always been fascinated by different numbers. But in recent times, 3 has become a magic number in many, many ways. But prior to the composers have used even patterns of 11s or 4s. You will see different kinds of composers using them, embedding them in their varnams or some of their chitaswarams and so forth. So we'll actually have clear-cut evidence of the intent of the composers when they embed it in madhyama kalams. Or now, for example, if you take Muthuswami Dikshita's Tyagaraja Yoga Vaibhavam, you'll see the intent of embedding that Sotav Hayati or Gopacheti and those things. Similarly, Uthikara Venkata Kavi, in one of his compositions, has created a pattern of 11 sixes to come from Samam 2 plus 2 in Adithala Monkalai in a particular composition. And then you see Poochi Srinivasa Iyengar, famous Chitaswaram Paramapavana Rama, where he has put 4 sixes. So like this, there are so many examples that one can see, and even in Varanams you'll see so many times composers having 3 fives and so forth. So, but the concept of Korvais as we know it today, I'm not going to go too deep into initial definitions or distinctions between Korvai, Muktayam, Tirmanam, all these things, because much of this elite audience already knows about these things. And I'll just straight go into this very fundamental thing. A Korvai, if you are taking at a very initial level, in fact, you can just take it from any part of the tala, but make sure that we land right. So in other words, the fundamental level of the Korvai doesn't really require to be taken from any specific part. Even today we see several Korvais which are played by eminent artists, which are taken from any part of the tala to express a beautiful thought, to express a beautiful concept, to express a beautiful pattern. And it sounds elegant. At the core of this topic is elegance and aesthetics. Mathematics is not necessarily a dry subject, nor is Sarva Lagu all about only chaturashram or even patterns. Sarvam Lagu is what? Even the most complex mathematics should appear easy to the listener. So that's the core of our spirit of this presentation. And then you go to the next level, where we try to create Korvais for say 64 aksharams or whatever aksharams of the tala that is there from samam to samam. That's just one degree higher in sophistication in terms of the concept. And then what happens? we can actually take from Samam and end it on the edam of the song, whether it is two after the beat or four after the beat or two before the beat or one before the beat and so forth. So Atita Managatam in the Mari Edithurke Samatrend Mudikaramadi is a beautiful concept too. All these require slightly next levels of thinking. And then of course we can always have Korvais in multiple gatis which add to the beauty of music. And all these are involving thought processes by us, calculations. We really need to sit and do some elementary level of arithmetic in order to arrive at this Korvais. We have to still try and express. So that there is a little bit of intellect that is going into this. There is some homework that has to be done for these kind of things. But they are not very difficult because mathematically all that we are doing in Carnatic music most of the times is covered in probably 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th standards of what we learn in school. In basic level of arithmetic. We are not doing Korvais with M is equal to E is equal to MC squared level of or binomial theorem involving kind of things or anything like that at all. We don't do Korvais with say calculus and that kind of things. We just calculate with arithmetic. So it's not very difficult to do this Korvais. In other words, once we get a little bit of the basic concepts and basic mathematics right, all our energies can cheerfully be then focused on the aesthetics of it. How to make that more beautiful, how to make that more beautiful in rhythm, how to make it more beautiful in melody. For instance, all Korvais will not work for all ragas. Because in ragathil irukkira prayogathukku vandu gathi thani inda adina ipo sadhana mari things kulla vandu adu nanna irukadu. So adukkulla we have to start working on the next levels of how to present the korvai, what korvais will suit which raga, and ragatha ottiye namma korvai create panna mudiyuma. Sari mal bani des re mal bani des mal bani des andha mari mukari vechi ipo andha aarohana avarohana andha prayogatha vechi aesthetically namma edho panna mudiyuma. Indha mari things alla we have to start actually applying, and that's what a real musician will aim to do. But these are all like what I call as man-made Korvais because they involve our effort. So now we come on to the concept of natural Korvais. Korvais which are already there but just waiting to be discovered. So in a very simple manner, I have tried to demystify this concept to give us a simple definition. Patterns of usually two or more parts, from samam to samam or samam to edam, that do not have remainder indivisible by three, in talas which are indivisible by three. In other words, if we take a korvai in rupaka talam, almost anything will work in Rupaka Talam, because even an Adi Tala Korvai will mostly work in Rupaka Talam if we render it three times, because Tala itself is different. Almost any pattern will start working in Rupaka Talam most of the times. So there are different kind of challenges there which I will come to later. But if you take other talas which are commonly used, I am not going to go into too detailed talas which are not common. Limit myself to Adi Talam, Mishra Tapu, Khanda Tapu and so forth. Maximum Khanda Jati Tripura Talam and so forth. So in those kind of talas, when you are dealing with this simple level, when we look at it, an Adi talam in one kalai is 32 aksharams, which is not divisible by 3. If it is two kalais, it is 64 aksharams, which is again not divisible by 3. And so in those kind of talams, how can we create seamless korvais? It has been done before by people. I am not the first to do this. There have been so many other people who have done this. Some of it would be obvious, but still not commonly used. That's the point here. So now one of the ways in which we have to look at those kind of korvais is, many times we are talking about 64 aksharams, and if we want to have a korvais like ta, di, 10 tick 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 t because it is 64 minus 45. So on the 19 la enna pandrom, then we still want to continue the theme of 5 in that. So we are forced to give two karvais in between those 5s. So this is the basic challenge at the very fundamental level that we face. If you want a reminder of 15 in a tala of 64, then the first part of the korvai has to be, let's say, call it part A. That has to be 49 units. If you want a reminder of 21, then the A has to be 43, which is actually a prime number. Similarly, if you want a reminder of 27, A has to be 37. So this is the basic challenge we face, and then generally we like, you know, symmetry, and so we are then forced to give some patchwork. What we are doing in that karvai, however nice it sounds, the reality is that it is still a patchwork that we are doing there to make it sound aesthetic. Otherwise the korvai would have only been 60 units. Simple level mathematical problem. But the solutions for this, in fact, if we look at mathematics as a concept, many such number theory problems have been very simple to start with, but their solutions sometimes took centuries to evolve. In fact, mathematician like Srinivasa Ramanujam was known for solving a lot of such problems which had been plaguing people for centuries, and he came up with elegant solutions. But now the classic korvai, many of these require multi-layered thinking, so we just cannot do it at the fundamental level of arithmetic. And then what actually happens is also, because I also discussed this with a bunch of mathematicians here and there, some of the patterns that we were talking about, they would say is not part of normal textbooks that they use for the sequences and number series and so forth. And then some of these, some of it is literally fluke, some of it is accidental. And a couple of them which are there, now for example, one of the beautiful korvais that I have always liked from childhood, which has been involved, is tadin tam, takadadin tam, takadina tadin tam, tatikitatom, 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 tatikitatom. Absolutely seamless korvai this is. There is no korvai of plus 2 or plus 1 that's happening in this entire korvai, if you notice. And this is what I mean by seamless korvai. This is the classic seamless korvai that has been used by almost all the major masters of both melody and rhythm for decades. And so now how we are going to be using more of this, and definitely a lot of mridangists are using some of these patterns. So I'm going to share a couple of them here. Yes, that's what. But that said, I'm sure that a lot of it are being used, but at the same time, they're not commonly heard in concerts most of the time, because I'm playing with so many artists and still I don't hear many of them. Yes, exactly. Yeah. I'm sure that there are sound reasons for not using them. But why I'm trying to share this is because it's not merely applicable to melody, to percussion only, because it's definitely used for melody. And melody artists are the ones, in fact, all my korvais are melodically renderable, and which is where my focus is anyway. But if you take a simple progressive korvai, some of the very obvious ones. Now if you take Takadimita Ketakam, well, Radha Mavi Padam Matam. Again, no remainder in that last 5. So you are able to get a progressive Srota Vahayati, which is again a very beautiful kind of way to do this. Now if you do that just with 2 ways, we can do that. So in the மாதிரி வந்து நம்ம பண்ணச்ச ஒரு kind of normal pattern that is easily followable. When you render this kind of patterns in concerts, again my focus is that they should be easy on the ears. And they should be easy for the accompanist to come along with us. The concert should not become like a quiz or a contest for the people on stage or off stage. So, the Korvais should appear very easy but still have something in it. There should be that instant appeal plus take-home value. And that is what is a hallmark of good Korvais. Of course, sometimes we definitely like to camouflage easy things and make it appear difficult. So that is another part of artistry. Sometimes you like to showcase simple as sophisticated. Sometimes you like to make sophisticated appear simple. All this is part of art, and that's the beauty of art. Otherwise, everything will be just science when you just state it straight. Now, there is a beautiful... So this is like what I call as a progressive but with additional parts. So when we are having the same kind of pattern happening, each time you are adding extra pattern. So 2, 3, 4, and then next time it's going to be 2, 3, 4, 5, and then it's going to be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Whichever way you want to visualize it, 2. If you want to visualize it as 0 plus 2 Korvais, 1 plus 2 Korvais, 2 plus 2 Korvais, whichever way we visualize it, the result is the same out there. And then we can have inverted progressions. I'm giving some of these fancy names only for the reason that students who are here can start working on these concepts and create many more things. Each pattern that I'm explaining actually is just one sample here, and literally dozens and dozens can be created by all of you here. So now you take a look at something very simple. So you can enter all these things 3 times. I'm only entering once because of the clock. So now again, this pattern, if you see, is a double layered progression. Actually, it's an inverted progression in one way. This term, which is 3, 3, 3, first time, and then you are having one condom for that. And then you are having 3, 3 only, 2 times you are having. So one side it is actually diminishing, but the other side it is increasing. So you are having 2 mishrams with that 2 mishrams Korvais over there. And third time it's going to be 1, 3 with 3 sankinas. So you are having 2 layers happening in this. But see how easy it is to render. Even for a child to accompany, it will be very easy to follow. But the beauty of it is that it can be almost used for any raga. This is like a generic kind of Korvais that can be useful for any raga. Now you see progressive in second part. This is again slightly more, it'll appear a little more sophisticated when we render it. So it is very, very interesting way to make it sound slightly involved. And then now this is another beautiful concept to start a song after 4. Now in Adithalam, if you want to render, almost any Korvai can be rendered from samam to samam in speeds of 3, 2, and 1, because 3 plus 2 plus 1 is equal to 6, which is going to fit into 3 avartanas most of the times. Now, simple example let me give. தடிந்தான் 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 தடி கேட்டதும் தடி கேட்டதும் தடி கேட்டதும் தா அப்படின்றது ஒரு ஆவர்த்தனத்தில் நம்மளுக்கு வந்துடுது. இதே நம்ம ரெண்டு தடவை சொல்ல இப்போ தடிம் தாம் தடிம் தாம் அந்த ஸ்பீட சொல்லிட்டுனா ரெண்டு ஆவர்த்தனத்தில் வரும் தடிம் தாம் தடிம் தாம் அப்படி மூணு மூணு கருவியாக கொடுத்து சொல்லிட்டுனா மூணு ஆவர்த்தனத்தில் வரும். ஸோ எல்லாமே சமத்துலேயும் சமத்துக்கு ஈஸியாக வந்துடும். பட் சப்போஸ் வி ஹாவ் அ சாங் லைக் ஏதா உணரா and we still are fascinated by this concept of rendering it in three speeds. So that involves a little more different kind of calculation. Now, three speed Korvais before after someone, right? Hmm. So, try and do that. Okay? This involves a slightly different kind of calculation, but see how beautiful it's sounding when it's rendered in the three speeds in a melody concept. Especially these are all, as I said, more and more of melody concept based chorus. Of course, when you play the same kind of concepts in rhythm, you have to know a lot more other kind of patterns to make it intricate and detailed, and typical rhythmic solos have to be used. And now, you can have this second part kind of progression. Several examples are there, but I'll come back to that later on because I want to show something else here. This concept of dovetailing patterns, where part A, part of part A becomes part of the first part of part B. And the Antak Chari Mari, number Idrodi, ending syllable becomes the opening syllable of something. So it becomes like that. So either rumba beautiful patterns can be rendered. The beauty of this is when somebody already renders this, it will sound very obvious. So now let us take a couple of these. So basically what is happening here? அப்படின்றது வந்து மட்டும் இட் அப்பியர் லைக் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பார்ட். But that also becomes the tatikitatam alone becomes part of the second part, which is 3/5. So ta ti ta ti ke ta tum ta ti ta ti ke ta tum ta ti ta ti ke ta tum ta ti ke ta tum ta ti ke ta tum ta ti ke ta tum. So that is the concept there. So there are several beautiful possibilities there. So ta ti ke ta. So that the gate 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 so that three times idla everything is three times in a typical concept. So now we see basically that the concept behind it is explained by me in the last paragraph. And now, before I go on further, I want to share with you the concept of boomeranging patterns. This boomerang pattern is the fancy name which is bayapadutha onnume illa. Actually, vandu illa adu vandu adha. So the idea there is, now if you look at these numbers like 7, 12, 15, 16, these are typically the events of Kusmari things, so the numbers could find out the next few numbers have been solved. So on the many things to wonder what is the actual way in which some of these patterns can be formed, updated, there is no particular textbook which will actually prescribe those patterns. So some of these are double layered. So for example, if you take 7 into 1, 6 into 2, 5 into 3, 4 into 4, and then if you go next pattern, then you go back to 5 into 3, 6 into 2. So like this, then basically you are going back to the same kind of thing. So the pattern will start like this and come back. So we can apply that in music sometimes. So when we do that, we are doing much of these things instinctively, by the way. Much of these things can be done instinctively. I'm just trying to only codify some of this so that intellectual developments can then start taking place in these areas. So now if you take ta, di, ta, ki, ta, ta, ka, di, ta, tiki, ta, ta, tiki, ta, ta, tiki, ta, ta, ta. So you see how beautifully that seamless part B is created by this. The 43 aksharams, basically, you are able to express as 12, 15 and 16. If you now use normal layer of thinking, we can never come up with 43 like this. Because typically our thinking will go in some other way. ஏதாவது நடுவில் கார்வையை கொடுத்து நம்ம பண்ணலாம், இல்லைன்னா நம்மளுக்கு அதுக்கு இந்த செகண்ட் பார்ட்ல கார்வையை கொடுக்கணும் அப்படின்ற ஒரு நெசசிட்டி வரும். This kind of thinking, this boomeranging concept, eliminates the need to think like that. An extreme example of that is what I've shared in the next one. Whatever thing that we can enter in that. So there, the actual mathematics there, the last part which will appear like Mishram is not Mishram at all. That is a little bit of magic which is involved in that one. So ta, ga, 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 ga. Actually, if you want to do it, ta, ga, ta, ga, 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 ta, ga, ga, ki, ta, ga, ta, ga, di, mi, ta, ga, ta, ki. Taka de me taka, that thick it at 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 that. So that is actually 3 tenths. A 3 tenths to become like 7. That is the thing over there. So now I want to share one more small concept called the concept of keyless Korvais. Until now, whatever I said could be explained and understood and developed using the key. Typically in a three-part Korvai, when it is rendered in the most sophisticated way, this I am saying, some of these are very obvious to the great artists who are present here, but some of these I am still stating them because the students should learn to start looking at this, especially when you are accompanying a main artist in violin or mridangam. Typically when they render, look for the second pattern. Most of the time that will be the average of the first of the three patterns. So you generally start honing in on the second pattern, you start seeing the key, and then many times you can immediately repeat it back. So this is something. So when you are looking at this kind of Korvais, many of the Korvais that I presented in 3 avatams, actually there is a simple key involved in that. I'm just hiding the key in that. But here what I'm doing is, even I don't have the key to some of these Korvais. basically what I call as the keyless Korvais. Now, you cannot arrive at them just by logic, because they cannot. You cannot be creating more and more using that concept further sometimes. Now, if you take something very simple. Now you see, in this one, it is 128 aksharams, but you are having a three-part Korvai in that for 128 in Adi Talam, which is actually having three khandams, three mishnams, and three sankirtans. So in other words, this is not something that you can arrive at logically to create this one. So again, to just, I'll say this whole thing again in solus. So that is the second part is not the average of the whole three patterns. That is what I'm trying to say here. In other words, that is totally beyond normal mathematical calculations. So you see again, so see the beauty of this. So that is the kind of pattern. One more thing which is one Korvai but in three parts, which is in three different speeds. This is different from the same Korvai rendered in three speeds, which I did earlier. But here it is one Korvai itself that has three parts which are in three speeds. Again, this is the second part is not the average in this also. Now you see. It just comes accidentally or just by fluke only. So, but of course, even to create accidents, we have to drive rationally and keep exploring into all kinds of places. So, now that this is there, then my mind actually tries to see how we can actually extend that concept into other talas. Now comes the second layer of thinking and see how beautifully we can apply that to a tala like Khandajati Tripura Talam, which is divisible by three. Now here the challenge is to do Korvais for edipus which are not on Samam, from Samam, so that the number Samathilendu இடத்துக்கு பண்ணச்ச இந்த மாதிரி தாளத்தில் ஆப்வியஸ்லி இது அதனால் வந்து டிவிசிபிள் பை த்ரீ. ஸோ நம்ம என்னவே பண்ணாலும் கோர்வை வந்து த்ரீ டைம்ஸ் வரணும், ஆனால் அந்த இடத்துக்கு வந்து இன்டிவிசிபிள் பை த்ரீயா வரணும். இதுதான் சேலஞ்ச். சும்மா ஒரு எக்ஸாம்பிளுக்கு ஒரு எடுப்பு இந்த மாதிரி கால் இடத்துல இருக்கு அப்படின்னா அந்த சமம் டு பிளஸ் டூ இன் கண்டுதாத்துக்கிட்டிருக்காங்க கைண்ட் ஆஃப் திங். ஸோ அதுக்கு வந்து ஐ ஆக்சுவலி யூஸ்டு சம் ஆஃப் தோஸ் அதர் கான்செப்ட்ஸ் டு எக்ஸ்டெண்ட் தட். ஸோ அப்படி வரும் அந்த பேட்டர்ன். So it is Parama Parnara. So again that
said no. That also can be done in this. அப்படி அதை எந்த எக்ஸ்டெண்ட் பண்ணிச்சுன்னா இதுக்கு வி ஆர் பேசிக்கலி யூசிங் அப்ளைங் த பிரின்சிபிள் ஆஃப் த கீலெஸ் ஒர்வை டு திஸ் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் ப்ராப்ளம் சமம் டு பிளஸ் த்ரீ இன் கண்ட ஜாதி கொடுத்தாலும் பேசிக்கலி யூ ஆர் டாக்கிங் அபவுட் 73 அக்ஷரஸ் ஸோ அதுக்கும் வந்து லாட் ஆஃப் பியூட்டிஃபுல் பேட்டர்ன்ஸ் கேன் பி யூஸ் அப்படின்னு மூணு தரம் ரெண்டு பண்ண அது மூணு தள்ளி வந்துடும் சோ இந்த மாதிரி லாட் ஆஃப் பியூட்டிஃபுல் திங்ஸ் இப்போ மிஸ்டர் சாப்பில் சும்மா ஒரு ஸ்மால் கான்செப்ட் சுவாதி தனவ ஜவந்தி புஷ்பவி கலசப்ரிய இங்க நம்ம சுரம் போட்டு வரோம் சோ ஆதித்தாளம் ஒன் கலை அப்படின்னு நம்ம போச்ச நம்மளுக்கு இன்னும் கொஞ்சம் சேலஞ்ச் ஜாஸ்தி தான் பிகாஸ் நம்மளுக்கு அக்ஷரங்கள் கம்மி ஸோ வந்து ததிந்தாம் 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 ததி கிட்டதும் ததி கிட்டதும் ததி கிட்டதும் அப்படின்ற ஒரு கோர்வை நம்ம வி எண்ட் அப் ஹியரிங் இட் ஒன்லி மில்லியன் டைம்ஸ் அண்ட் தென் சம்டைம்ஸ் வி ஆல்சோ ஹியர் சம் வெரி எலிகன்ட் பட் டெக்னிக்கலி அர்த்தமெட்டிக்கலி questionable corvais like tatton tagadon tagetadon tagigetadon 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 see the intent of man has been there to create that second part seamless so he has to compromise in the first part to make that happen so tatton tagadon both are the same thing but he is camouflaging that tatton and to appear like it is 1 plus 1 over there so but that intent is very cute so but then No, I subscribe to both. I can see both sides of the coin. So I'm absolutely fine with just aesthetics superseding arithmetic sometimes. And at other times, I also see the arithmetic beauty itself also coming into play and still being rendered with aesthetics. So there is no contest here. But if you take a look at tam ta tam ta ka tam ta ke ta tam ta tik ke ta ta tik ke ta ta tik ke ta ta tam, it's a very simple example for Aditalam, which you can still be seamless. And then the second one, one of my favorite examples which I have spoken about before. Very 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 தகாம் தகதாம் தகிட்டதாம் தகதினதாம் தக தகிட்டதாம் தகதிமி தகிட்ட அப்படின்னு வருது அப்படின்னு க்வெஸ்சன் வரும் ஸோ ஒன் பிளஸ் டூ டூ பிளஸ் டூ அப்படின்னு பார்த்துன்னா ஃபைவ் பிளஸ் டூ முடிஞ்சவுடனே செவன் வந்துடும் அந்த மாதிரி நம்மளுக்கு ஒரு ஃபீலிங் வரும் ஆனால் அதை அப்படி பார்க்கக்கூடாது அதுதான் அங்கே பியூட்டிஸ் த பியூட்டி ஆஃப் மேத் மேத்ல உங்களுக்கு வந்து மாயை பார்க்கணும்னா இந்த மாதிரி திங்ஸ்ல பார்க்கலாம். So 1 plus 2 அப்படி நம்ம வியூ பண்றதுனால தான் நம்மளுக்கு அந்த கான்ஃப்ளிக்ட் வருது. We should view it as 2 plus 1. தக தகிட தகதிமி தக தகிட தகதிமி தக தகதிமி தகிட தா. So 2 plus 1, 3 plus 1, 4 plus 1, 5 plus 1, 6 plus 1 and 7. That is the actual way to view the progression. So you see how the same fact is there, but how perspective makes it appear right or wrong. So that is the entire beauty of both mathematics and music, which is encapsulated here. Again, Adhidharathile number 6 thalli aarambikkirathukku sila romba beautiful things. So many other solutions can work. அதாவது சொல்றது நான் கச்சேரியில வாசிக்கிறேன். So three speed solution for ஆதி தாளம் ஆஃப்டர் சமம். Again a beautiful concept this is. நம்ம the three speeds அப்படி நம்ம அந்த range ல போச்சுன்னா beautiful concepts keep appearing on our thing. I'm sharing this so that you can all students especially can develop a lot more with this. So So see how grand it will sound in the three speeds when it is rendered like that. Now the same Korvais, the beauty of that, padintam takadinna takadinna tam padigita takadinna takadinna tam padigita takadinna takadinna tam padigita takadigita takadigita. Same concept is that, but that how it fits into the three columns, the same thing is of course again it's a keyless thing because there is no key in which it actually fit into that one. Adu vandu namba vandu logic la develop panna mudiyadhu three speeds la. Adu just it's one of those natural beauty that exists in numbers that just happens. Other gatis, I'm just touching upon very simple. There's a beautiful thing here. I noticed here. Other gatis, I'm just touching upon very simple. There is a beautiful thing here. I noticed here. So the khanda gati, for instance, nariya nalla korvais la beautiful la namba render panna mudiyum, but a nice concept which is so aesthetic. Ta ka ta ki ta. So taka 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 taka. Now let me just quickly share in the things like other concepts which we could try out. The
series of numbers where you start with any two numbers and keep on adding the last two to form patterns. So in this case, it is 3 plus 4. 3 and 4 are the initial numbers. So you add those 3 and 4, you get 7. And then you add that 4 to 7 to get 11. And then add that 7 to 11 to get 18. Namari number, that's a series of numbers which was actually propounded by an Indian mathematician much, much earlier. Pingala had propounded this concept much earlier, almost between 450 and 200 BC apparently. But Aparma is now known as the Fibonacci or Fibonacci series. So, all this doesn't mean that some of this may actually sound aesthetic when you render it. But simply as an experiment, I just... It'll sound like this. I just wanted to share that with you. And if you want to use the squares of numbers as your first part. So it can still sound aesthetic when we render it in a particular manner. But anyway, let me conclude. My intent of this is to, of course, share the beauty of mathematics and what I actually initially called as mathemagic. To Papu sir, and then you said, conservative title, Pera Kudu sir. Then I changed it to this. So there is so much of magic in music, even without math. But if math also can be added to create more magic, the whole thing can be so much more beautiful.